I want to pick up where my colleague across the aisle, Congressman Himes, left off earlier. Respectfully, Dr. Hill, he was not defending you. He was defending himself and Democrats. I want to make sure the record's very clear. Ranking Member Nunes was correct. He correctly noted in his opening that Republicans, not Democrats on this committee, were the first ones to raise the issue of Russian interference in the 2016 election. The disagreement wasn't about Russian meddling. The disagreement was about whether or not President Trump conspired with Russia, a false allegation peddled by the Democrats generally and specifically by some Democrats on this committee. With that, Mr. Holmes, I want to turn to you and the part of the conversation, your testimony where you said you heard President Trump say, is he going to do the investigation? And Ambassador Sondland said he's going to do it. He'll do anything you ask him to. Is that right?
Yes, sir.
What did President Trump say next?
He said, good, what about Sweden?
He said what?
Sir, I need to look at back where we are in the middle of the conversation here. Where are we from the testimony? Exactly. So then they turned to the Sweden conversation.
What did President Trump say next?
He said, good, what about Sweden?
Good, what about Sweden? Good, what about Sweden? Why isn't that in the in your statement?
Sir, it's not a word for word, every single word in the conversation.
But it's the most important part of the conversation.
Well, then they turned to Sweden. They turned to the other topic.
Respectfully, Mr. Holmes, this impeachment inquiry is based on the call the day before where President Trump, as part of a bribery scheme, as part of an extortion scheme, as part of a quid pro quo, according to the Democrats, demanded investigations in exchange for either military aid or a White House meeting. And the next day, you were witness to President Trump receiving word that the bribery scheme was successful, the extortion scheme was successful. And his response was, good. What about Sweden?
Yes, sir. The Ukraine portion of that conversation was extremely brief.
What was the first thing the president said on the call?
You
had a clear recollection of this conversation.
Yes, sir.
Mr. Ratcliffe, please allow Mr. Holmes to answer.
Yes, sir. Sondland greeted the president.
How?
He said, hello, Mr. President, I'm in Ukraine. I'm in Kyiv. And the president said, are you in Ukraine?
You think he said, I think you're in Ukraine? He said what?
He said, are you in Kyiv, Ukraine?
What did you hear President Trump say about ASAP Rocky?
I did not hear President Trump side of the conversation about ASAP Rocky.
You said, how did we go from the conversation was very loud and his voice was recognizable to, as you say here, when the conversation shifted, I could only hear Ambassador Sondland's side of the conversation.
Yes, sir, as I've testified. The initial part of the call, Ambassador Sondland, sort of when the president came on the call, he sort of winced and held the phone away from his ear for the initial portion of the call. And then at some point in the call, he stopped doing that. And I don't know why. I don't know if he turned the volume down. I don't know if the president spoke less, more quietly. I don't know if he got used to the volume. I don't know what changed.
What did change? It's important. This was memorable.
I don't know, sir. It was Ambassador Sondland stopped moving the phone away from his ear.
That's what it was?
Yes.
Okay. How did the conversation end?
I only heard Ambassador Sondland's side of the conversation, sir. And at the end of the conversation, he was giving the president advice on how to deal with this ASAP Rocky situation. And he said, they should have released him on your word, and you can tell the Kardashians you tried.
Okay. So to be clear, when President Trump received word that President Zelensky had agreed to the investigations, he said, good. What about Sweden?
Yes.
Okay. When exactly did Gordon Sondland ask President Zelensky about the investigations?
I'm sorry, sir.
When did he ask about the investigations?
When did Gordon Sondland ask Zelensky about the investigations?
Yeah.
You're asking in which meeting did he raise the investigations?
Well, it was raised the day before on a call, and the next day, Gordon Sondland said the answer to that was he's going to do the investigation. So when did he ask about the investigations?
My assumption is he did it in the closed-door meeting with Yermak.
Well, I don't want to...
Time of the gentleman has expired.
I appreciate that, but I want to make sure the record's clear that yesterday Ambassador Sondland testified that the topic of conversations did not come up on that day. I yield back.
Time of the gentleman has expired.